In this video, I'll introduce our Google Home sample app for Matter, which showcases the Google Home Mobile SDK, available from Google Play Services. Hi there. I'm Emily, part of the Nest Partner Engineering team at Google. At Google, we understand that mobile apps play a big role in managing smart home devices. If you'd like to build your own Android apps to support Matter devices, we can help you get started fast. Our mobile APIs for Matter can easily be added to your Android Studio projects, allowing you to commission and share devices right from your app. You can also use our sample app as a learning tool to better understand key Matter concepts, as well as a tool to debug and troubleshoot interactions with Matter devices. To demonstrate the core features of our Google Home mobile APIs, we'll use an Android 12 device, along with an ESP32 development board. Our sample app only supports devices that have the on/off server attribute, for example, lights, smart plugs, and fans. For this video, we'll use the all clusters example from the Matter GitHub repository, linked in the comments below. I'll get started by opening the project in Android Studio. While Gradle syncs, I'll make sure that my ESP32 is plugged into a power source and ready to start advertising. Next, I'll go ahead and run the sample app on my Android phone. Before you can control devices and allow them to communicate with each other within the same fabric, they need to be commissioned by a commissioner, which in this case is our sample application. To commission our ESP32, we'll need to use the CommissioningClient API. We can do this by tapping the Add Device button in our sample app. Now, let's watch my teammate Pierre commission a Matter device using the sample app on an Android phone. First, he'll open up the sample app on his Android phone. When he taps the Add button from the home screen, control is transferred to Google Play Services. When his app makes a call to the Commissioning Client API, all of the commissioning work and associated screens are handled by Google Play Services and not the sample app. This functionality provides a consistent user experience and removes the need to handle sensitive permissions like Wi-Fi and thread credentials. When the discovery process is complete, he can enter a custom name for the device. Now that commissioning is completed, control is transferred back to our sample app. During the commissioning process, Pierre's ESP32 device was added to the Google Fabric using the Commission Device API. This means that he can now control it through the Google Home app, Android Power Controls, Voice, and Nest touchscreen devices. So how does the Commissioning Client API work? Let's head back over to Android Studio and find out. In our Commission to Google function, first, a commissioning request object is defined. Matter is the entry point for the Google Home Mobile SDK. In the next call, the getCommissioningClient function gets a commissioning client by the fragment activity. The commissionDevice method accepts the commissioning request. The success callback of the commission device method provides an intent sender to launch the commission device activity in Google Play Services. Here, we use live data objects to report the results of our API call. That was the minimum code required to commission a device to Google's fabric. But what if you'd like to commission devices to another fabric? To manage and control devices directly within our sample app, we'll need to create a local fabric and obtain the operational credentials needed to commission devices. Let's see how that's done. We can inform the Google Home Mobile SDK that we'd like to commission devices to a local fabric by passing a custom service to the commissioning request object. In this example, we pass app commissioning service. With this modified flow, the commissioning client API commissions devices to the Google Fabric first, then returns a callback to the service that we passed. Let's take a look at the app commissioning service next. To commission devices to a development fabric, first we override the OnCommissioningRequested function, which returns a commissioning request metadata object. This metadata gives our sample app access to the device information that Google Play Services received when it connected to the ESP32 device. In this example, we log the members, including the device type, vendor ID, and network information. In addition to the Google Home Mobile SDK from Google Play Services, our sample app also includes commissioning and cluster libraries from the Matter GitHub repository, Connected Home IP, which again is linked below. Remember, this local fabric will only exist on the instance that it's created on. If you install the sample app on a different Android device, your Matter devices will need to be recommissioned. Before we go on, it's important to remember that local fabrics are for development only and shouldn't be used in production. Let's go see how to use these libraries to create our development local fabric. To perform local commissioning, we can pass the device information returned in the commissioning request metadata object. The ChipClient uses this metadata to create a secure channel between the Google Home sample app for Matter and your device. Then we use the await commission device function to start the commissioning process. Now that you better understand how to use the commissioning client API, let's look again at the home screen of our sample app. Earlier, when Pierre commissioned his ESP32 device, his instance of the sample app was using our custom app commissioning service. This means that the Matter-enabled lighting device now participates in two fabrics, Google Home and a local fabric. Each fabric has its own set of credentials and a unique 64-bit fabric ID. Commissioning to a development fabric allows you to use the libraries from the Matter GitHub repository to control devices from the sample app. Here's an example of how we can use Matter's chip client to get a pointer to commission devices, then toggle them on and off. To demonstrate this functionality, Pierre can toggle his ESP32 on and off right from the home screen of the sample app. In the previous examples, we learned that the Google Home Mobile SDK makes it possible to commission devices to the Google Fabric and also to a local fabric, an example of multi-admin flow. All of that was possible using the commission device method. Next, let's talk about the share device method, which allows you to open a temporary commissioning window for devices, change the state of your devices, enabling them to be commissioned to another fabric, and control your devices from other apps and ecosystems. To demonstrate this functionality, Pierre has installed two separate instances of the sample app on his phone. The first instance represents his primary ecosystem, where he's already commissioned the device. The second app represents a sharing recipient, which is the target commissioner. First, he'll open the primary app instance, then select the commissioned device. From the details screen, he taps Share. The sample app makes a call to the ShareDevice API, and once again, control is transferred to Google Play Services. A share sheet displays where he can select other apps to share the ESP32 device with. Here, he selects the second instance of the sample app. Acting as the target commissioner, the second instance of the app completes the commissioning of the device into its own fabric. He can name the device anything he wants in the second app, the same or different. Both apps now have control over the ESP32 device. Let's go back to Android Studio and see how Pierre did this. We can still use the commissioning client to share devices, but this time we'll declare a share device request. The device descriptor provides specific information about the device, such as its vendor ID, product ID, and device type. We'll also set the device name. Next, we set the commissioning window and pass the device discriminator and passcode. Now that our ShareDevice request is set up, we get a commissioning client, then call the ShareDevice function. Once again, we'll use live data objects to report the results of our API call. Our Google Home sample app for Matter also includes a settings screen and developer utilities to help you test and debug your own apps. You can print data store repositories to Logcat and create fake devices to simplify your development process. That's all for our sample app demo. Be sure to check back soon for Google Play Services updates, code labs, and sample app downloads, and don't forget to follow the links in the comments below. Thanks for watching!